want to cook and sew. I mean, I love to eat, but not make a career, you know, out of it. So here I am, I'm struggling. I'm like, no, my future, I just don't see it. So we're going to distract me at the National Stadium. Girls strike, you know that, it's pop. So, you know, the courts, I'm going to say, all right, this is where everybody going to see me now. So we have to start that boat, you know? So I got to get ready. Now, again, I told you I was on the field, right? So I'm at the stadium and I see all these country girls in the beer tank. You know the country girls in class, right? You know, all the I've never run against them before, right? And me and my brother, none of the country food just eat them under the stamina, them fast. So here I am now, you know, I'm taller than everybody, I'm good to go, right? So, and I get, you know, the coach is saying, you know, the first seat, you don't have to go so fast, you know, save the energy. So I'm on the first seat, all right, good. Second eight. Finals, ready to go now. So now blow this up, get no scholarship. And I get set, by the time the man said, go, the beer girl reach out the finish line already. How the heck? And I'm there devastating. I lost. I said, no man, I made the teacher a little shy for one that beat me. No, nobody got gonna give me any scholarship. So here I am now. Again, I'm in this position. I have 1 year left and I am stuck. Now the girls in my community, half of them around my age, some dropped out of school, a few were pregnant. And it was just, there was no one to like look at it and say, I'm gonna follow her. There was no example. Again, I come from a place called Angola. They named it after Angola. Africa, so, you know, it was really bad. And, but I love Angola because there were some, you know, when you grow poor, you enjoy, you know, you're happy. You know, you're poor, but you're happy. You can't go, but somebody had to eat some of them dumplings and then the rodeo would come and help you when you're hungry. Or you can just, I mean, it just, I was a happy child, but there were struggles, okay? So here I am, I'm coming from track meet. I'm crying, wiping my eye, my life is over. And there are these two guys just standing. Coach from a white guy, never, you know, face to face with a white guy before, and a local Jamaican coach. And they said, I heard a call my name, like, where do you know my name from? So I walk up, I'm curious, you know. And he's like, the white guy said, and he has a funny accent, Oklahoma. Hey gal, like somehow, and he said, all I heard, I'm not gonna lie, scholarship. I hear scholarship, right? But he was like, he was saying, I'm gonna give you a scholarship in basketball if you learn to play the game within a year. And I'll let you have a scholarship. Tell the truth, never know basketball was. We hear scholarship. I said, yeah. And he said, that's what is basketball? And then local coach was trying to explain to me. So then, you know, he was talking. I said, in a year? Stop now. I said, no, kill me with it. Bring it home. I was determined. And from there on, you know, just ignored. Again, I have to either come from school to the stadium, which again, I have to have one bus fare. So if I decide if I'm going to walk to the stadium, take a bus to the stadium and then walk home. These are, I'm telling you, journeys. But I had to make that decision at the time that I needed an escape. This was my way out. Again, whatever situation you're in presently, I know as a student, I'm soon getting to there, especially when you're not from this country and hardship hits you, sometimes you just feel frustrated and you won't give up. Don't give up. You're destined to be great, but if you give up, you'll never know how great you'll be. Okay? So here I am, the year come, and I get a scholarship. And I went up to Oklahoma. Now again, this is a poor Jamaican. Jamaica without a jacket, okay? Nobody really prepared for the cold of Oklahoma, okay? Cowboys and Indians in America. Some of Oklahoma have cowboys and Indians. So you have this Jamaica between the cowboys and Indians that I used to watch on, you know, in TV in Jamaica, right? So I'm here, and the girls, the few girls are like, you from Jamaica, you're from Pantry? I'm saying, oh, so Jamaica have a lot of nice cars. I just don't own them, but they have nice cars. You know, they make fun. And the weed thing. Most of them are not weed. I'm Swiss and Jamaican. No, I can't say anything possibly because the drink glass behind me used to burn. It's a lot of that. So I think someone get high from him just smoking it. Another man never take a break. But apart from that, I'm just saying that, you know, they're, you know, people, they don't know us. And because, again, it's a small island, and everything that those people were so backward. But I was determined, right? So the first thing, when she said that, when he said that to me, I said, all right. Okay, so in other practices, again, think about it. I'm just training for a year, right? I just told you that. I'm going to train and everything. And so I'm not really, basketball is not just something, you know, these girls have been playing for a year. So I'm still a little bit awkward around history then. And as the season as it started, I started going to the gym. So I met two friends, a Japanese and an American Indian, Native American. And I asked them to rebound for me, and they come and they rebound. And every day I'm in the gym, because I said, if it's a skill game, and I learn my skill, I'm going to be better, right? It's a skill game. So I'm there practicing, and I asked the coach to help me. By the end of the year, I realized, wait a minute. You know, I see picture and a paper and everything, and that's nice, and you know, but you didn't even know how good you were getting. But my point was not about being anything except just trying to get to the next level, right? And the coach called me in his office and he said, Simone, listen, you're all American, second team. I said, coach, oh, you let them put all American name on all Jamaican. Coach, my mother would kill me. You know I'm Jamaican, coach, you let them put American. I have no idea what an all-American was. I didn't, you know, young girls and boys who play sport, that's something more, you know, American, that's, you know, prestigious in sports, but I didn't know. It wasn't, you know, that wasn't a goal. I just wanted to be good so I could get another scholarship and go to the big university. And so he said, second team. I'm going to say, oh. The next year, first team, called up, one of the nominees for player of the year, MVP for all the tournament. I was killing it 2 years. Again, whatever you're doing, if it's something that you just have to do, if it's math, if it's whatever, and you know you have to dedicate your time to it, stop putting it off. Dedicate your time to it. It's worth it. Okay, sometimes you don't put up our own things, right? I want to do everybody else's thing. Even work overtime for somebody else. And then for us, if you have something you want to work on for you, you put it off and on the time and time. No, to be great, to break barriers, you have to put the work in. No matter what anybody tells you. You know many people discourage me? Don't get discouraged by other work. They don't know your worth. They don't know your value. Don't let somebody tell you what you're worth and how much you value. It doesn't matter if you're not doing well now, you can't do well later.
True. Facts.
Nobody can tell you that. So I got all of this, and I'm not going to even take about the struggle. Again, poor Jamaican. the food, I couldn't eat it.